Albert Einstein, the creator of the theory of special relativity, is credited with having said that the grand aim of science is to cover the greatest number of empirical facts by logical deduction from the smallest number of hypotheses or axioms. In essence, the goal is to explain as much as we can with as few explanations as possible. But where did this idea come from? It can be traced back through history, touching on every science all the way back to the Dark Ages and a Franciscan monk teaching a radical new way of reasoning. His name? William of Occam. His invention? No less than the logical underpinnings of modern science, now known as Occam's razor. William of Occam was born around the year 1288 in the town of Occam, southwest of London, England. He was raised in a Franciscan friary, educated, and inducted into their order. His early education would have included learning basic arithmetic, reading the Bible, and studying the lives of the saints. He later received a bachelor's degree at a studium generale called Grey Friars, which was somewhere between a grammar school and a university. Let's just say, if you study anything but the classics, your college experience is likely much different from William's. The majority of the texts being used were many centuries old, with topics ranging from logic and arithmetic to geometry and astronomy. For the time, William of Occam was well educated, but the subjects have evolved a great deal since then. Astronomy, for example, was very different during the Dark Ages. At the time, the Earth was thought to be the center of the universe, and was also thought to be made of four classical elements: earth, water, fire, air. Everything else was mounted on concentric, perfectly transparent spheres that wheeled around us and provided the movements ancient cultures observed in the stars, planets, and moon. In addition, the Aristotelian understanding, a form of logical reasoning called realism, gave each and every object or entity a series of categories that had to be considered when discussing motion or change that an object or entity underwent. Sound complicated? It was. My primary source, Life is Simple by John Joe McFadden, devotes an entire chapter to explaining the mess that was Aristotelian realism, how it works, and the place it held in medieval science. To sum it all up, it was unwieldy and so intertwined with theology that it could explain everything up to and including miracles. While there is no evidence that William of Occam ever lost faith in God or miracles, he did argue and teach that reason and faith were separate fields. He argued that an omnipotent being, like the Christian God, did not need to conform to any level of human reason, and therefore could not be described using Aristotelian realism. As such, God was unknowable, which didn't fit with reasoned logic. In a way, an unknowable God could be considered an unnecessary complication to a reasoned explanation of the world. This, of course, got William into a bit of trouble. You see, at the time, questioning the omnipotence of God was a serious offense, and he was summoned to France to defend his views. Ultimately, he was accused of heresy and fled with several other friars to a more tolerant place where he wouldn't be burned at the stake, but not before his ideas began to spread. One early usage of Occam's razor was by the Merton Calculators of England. The calculators used the razor's concept to remove the realist elements preventing a mathematical depiction of velocity. Originally described by changes in place, time, location, and position, they narrowed the concept to the more familiar formula of distance traveled divided by time elapsed. This is the same formula used today by astronomers and physicists and taught in Physics 101 classes everywhere. After the invention of the printing press, about a century after William of Occam's death, his work began to spread more widely. Evidence of his influence is found in the works of Copernicus, Tycho Brahe, and Johannes Kepler, all of whom iterated the heliocentric model of the solar system with the razor's help. Kepler is perhaps most notable, since his use of the razor was to add complexity to the model of the solar system, since additional complexity is welcome with the razor, so long as it is necessary to explain what is observed in a reasonable way. This is the exact reasoning behind the theorized existence of dark matter and dark energy in modern physics, since they are each an arbitrary entity that explains an observation made of the universe that we cannot currently explain. Today, Occam's razor has many uses, from explaining why UFOs probably aren't alien spaceships, to helping doctors diagnose ailments and biologists determine the reasons for evolutionary change. Occam's razor aims to explain as much as we can without unnecessarily complicating things. It remains one of the basic building blocks of scientific reasoning. Hey guys, I'm Grant from Active Galactic. I wanted to say this video would not have been possible without the help of a book. Life is Simple, How Occam's Razor Set Science Free and Shapes the Universe, written by John Joe McFadden, is where I got the majority of the historical context for William of Occam, science in the Dark Ages, and how the effects of Occam's Razor rippled through history. It was an excellent read, and there was only so much I could include in our video. If you'd like to learn more about William of Occam, his world, or how his razor changed science for good, this would be a good place to start.